What's good, creators? Welcome back to Monzon Media. So I just found out that Canva has updated their video editor. I thought it'd be cool to, kind of react to this update with you together. And yeah, let's take a look. So once you're in Canva, go ahead and either create a new design or just click on video if it comes up here. And you're gonna see, the timeline and your workspace here, and obviously your menu on the left. So off the bat, I don't see anything new. So I'm gonna slide in some stock footage here. All right, and we still have our timeline. If we click on the clip itself, we still have a trim option, crop, flip, and animate, which I believe hasn't changed. Let's put in another clip here. And oh, there you go. We see transitions. Nice. All right, so we have dissolve, slide, circle wipe, and line wipe. Very cool. Now, yes, it's a little limited. I can imagine they're going to add more to this down the road. Yeah, this is definitely a good addition. I'm going to add another video clip here just to put in two transitions. See how that works. Let's put in slide. And this one, what did we put in? Let's put in circle wipe. Okay, so you can control the duration of the transition speed. 0.5 is usually a pretty decent length, or even 1 second. I'm going to change it to 1 second. Let's do the same for this one. Oh, I'm pressing add page, not transition. So yeah, you have two options here: transition, change transition, or add another page. There we go. And slide. Oh, look at this one. So slide has options for timing and direction. If you want it to come up from the top or bottom, that's cool. All right. Now, circle wipe had, oh, okay, it had in and out. So I guess all these transitions have different options. Does line wipe have something else? It's the same. Same as slide. And dissolve again just has duration. So that's not bad. I actually like that they put in transitions because that was one of the things that prevented me from recommending Canva for video editing. I'm going to cut this down to 4 seconds each, if you bear with me. So you can trim right here on the timeline just by grabbing, clicking on the clip, and then grab the side here. You'll see the arrows pop up, and you can change the duration. Or alternatively, if you click on the clip here in the workspace, you could change the length. Well, you could trim it here up in the upper area here. Now let's play this. Let's do a preview. Yeah, that works pretty well. I like that. Now I'm really wondering about the audio, so I'm just gonna pick something here, drag it on top. Okay. Now, what I'm wondering is, number one, are there any options for it? It says adjust here. Okay, so I guess I can adjust. Okay, I can adjust the starting points of the song. So let's play this from the beginning. I click on adjust here, either by the top or the three circles here. You can adjust the starting points. Let's see if we can add a second. Oh, yes, you can add a second audio track. So that's really cool. If you have a talking head video, you could put in some background. Now, I don't think, though, that it doesn't seem that there's no other controls other than adjusting the clip and volume, which you can increase or decrease, but so there's no fading in or out of the audio, which is kind of a bummer because, so let's say I wanted to put audio from this clip on. Guess I can move it, but there's no way for me to fade it in, you know what I mean? Like, it's just gonna be like an ab abrupt start and stop. See that? So let me play it from here. So yeah, it doesn't look like there's a way to transition the audio. However, this is still useful if you wanted to put in, some sound effects. So, see, like this sound effect is just a bird or a crow or whatever that is. But I can't even move. Oh, there you go. Okay, I must have hit something else. Maybe if I zoom in the timeline here. So this, if you didn't know, controls the timeline length. I'm going to widen that, and okay, you can move it. My mistake. So you just have to kind of grab it there. Click on the file and hold. It's a little buggy. It might be on my end because of my internet connection. But yes, you can move it around, which is great. Awesome. So again, I'd say, the lack of being able to fade the audio in and out is something to think about. Sometimes you want to have that transition between music, or maybe there's something in your vocal audio that you want to fade out or in. So I hope that they would put that in a future update. Yeah, so this looks all good. It's very simple, which is great because, it follows the theme of Canva, making everything easy for you, which I quite like. Now, in case you didn't know, the other thing you can do with videos is you can do picture in picture. So as you see with this clip, if I put something on top of it, you'll see it here on the page. And it actually pops the clip just on top here on the timeline, and you can just resize that. So again, let's say you're doing a talking head video, and if you got, you're teaching something, or if you got some B-roll to show, you could still put that video of yourself here in the corner for a picture-in-picture effect. So that's really nice. As I said, I'm all in favor for new things, and it's very simple, but it's very practical as well. What do you guys think of the new update? But for now, until the next video, I'll see ya when I see ya.